Well, welcome to today's Thought for the Day on Thursday the 2nd of July. I'm Suzanne Hoslett. Psalm 93. The Lord reigns, he is robed in majesty. The Lord is robed in majesty and armed with strength. Indeed, the world is established, firm and secure. Your throne was established long ago. You are from all eternity. The seas have lifted up, Lord, the seas have lifted up their voice. The seas have lifted up their pounding waves. Mightier than the thunder of the great waters, mightier than the breakers of the sea, the Lord on high is mighty. Your statutes, Lord, stand firm. Holiness adorns your house for endless days. Today's psalm is a short psalm about the sovereignty of God. Sovereign can be a noun or an adjective. As a noun, it means supreme ruler. And as an adjective, it means possessing supreme or ultimate power. So today's psalm is about the Lord, our Lord, as the supreme ruler with ultimate power over all of his creation. Psalm 93 is a short psalm, only 5 verses, so a short thought about each. Verse 1. The Lord reigns. He is robed in majesty. The Lord is robed in majesty and armed with strength. Indeed, the world is established, firm and secure. Robed in majesty and armed with strength. As I think of the robes, I remember Isaiah's vision of the Lord in Isaiah chapter 6. The Lord is high and lifted up, with his train filling the temple. And as I consider that image in my mind, I see a robe with a long flowing train, not just filling the temple, but a train beautifully embroidered with the most exquisite gold threads, covered in jewels that reflect the light. A robe so beautiful that it is dazzling, almost impossible to look at as it is so bright. It is the most stunning piece of clothing that could ever be seen. But our Lord, at the same time as being robed in majesty, is armed with strength. Maybe under that glittering, dazzling robe, he wears a suit of armour. One that shows his total power and might over all the dominion that he has created. And at the end of the verse we read, the world is established, firm and secure. This verse brings me such comfort just at the moment that no matter how insecure and unsteady we may feel with all that living life within the constraints of a pandemic brings, we are reminded that we have a Lord who is sovereign and who reigns in power and might over all of his creation. It is established, it is firm and secure, and it is in his hands. Verse 2. Your throne was established long ago, you are from all eternity. This verse reminds us of the fact that the throne of Christ is eternal, it is unchangeable. It always was, always is, and always will be. A fact that the writer to the Hebrews reminds us of when they say in Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. I love verses 3 and 4. The seas have lifted up, Lord. The seas have lifted up their voice. The seas have lifted up their pounding waves. Mightier than the thunder of the great waters. Mightier than the breakers of the sea. The Lord on high is mighty. As I read these verses, I'm reminded of the hymn written by Horatio Spafford, a hymn I suspect quite a lot of us know. A hymn he wrote after a series of very traumatic events in his life. The death of his 4-year-old son, followed by his own financial ruin, and finally, the receipt of a telegram from his wife, which simply read, "Saved alone." A telegram she sent when the ship, carrying her and their 4 daughters, sank following a collision with another ship in the Atlantic Ocean. As he passed the site of the sinking on his way to comfort his grieving wife, he wrote, "When peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll, whatever my lot thou hast taught me to know, it is well with my soul. Though Satan should buffet, though trials should come, let this blessed assurance control that Christ has regarded my helpless estate and hath shed his own blood for my soul. My sin, O the bliss of this glorious thought, my sin, not in part but the whole, is nailed to the cross, and I bear it no more. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I'm not sure the waves in our lives can ever be as big as those in Horatio Spafford's life. But no matter how big the waves we face are, how difficult they are to bear, we can always know that we have a Saviour who is mightier than any wave we face. A Saviour who died for each of us. He walks through each storm. He holds us above the waves. He is our comfort and our peace. Our souls can find rest in him. And after the storm in Psalm 93, we return to the temple. Verse 5. Your statutes, Lord, stand firm. Holiness adorns your house for endless days. The Lord's house, which through everything that hits it, stands firm, adorned in holiness forever. But let's also remember that this temple, the dwelling of our God, is where we will also be forever. 1 Peter 2 tells us, but you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. So one day, because of the cross, we will stand in that place, gazing on our majestically robed Lord, singing with the angels, declaring the praises of the sovereign Lord who has chosen each of us to be his special possessions. And the absolutely best bit? We will be able to do that forever. Amen.